I'm going to speak from a very accountable point of view right now. And that is the goal, right? Is to stop blaming my husband for my problems. Is when my boundaries are healthy and I'm holding my own and I'm not expecting him to fix me, he gets nervous and he crosses boundaries and he starts checking up on me and he starts finding things that are wrong with me and my behavior so that I have to apologize for it. That's what he's looking for. Last night we had a discussion. Probably took over an hour, and then we started to make dinner. But the discussion was not about my feelings of anxiousness about going to the movies with some friends tomorrow for my birthday. Discussion. I mean, I was like having a hard time because he had to point out to me that the movie has nudity in it, and I didn't think it would. I thought PG-13 didn't mean nudity. I thought it meant, you know, grown up talk, but not curse words. Grown up, you know, innuendos, but not actual nudity, you know? I really had a hard time when he told me that the movie has nudity in it, but go ahead, go see it anyway. Like, I wanted his explicit blessing, permission, approval, healthy version of him to be cool with me going. But no, he is struggling to let me go because it has nudity in it. So I had a hard time ordering the tickets anyway, despite what he feels, despite his issues. I had a hard time not psychoanalyzing him and not trusting him at his word when he said he's not happy about it, but he wants me to go. Tells me to go anyway. He never said he wanted me to go. So So I was battling myself. And then after that, he finally lets the cat out of the bag and tells me that he's insecure with my new therapist, who I've seen for a few weeks now, maybe over a month. Because I'm not bashing on him, I'm not talking crap about him, I'm not complaining about him. And he claims that he didn't even know his name. So he feels that this guy must be somebody that he should feel threatened by. And therefore, he has a hard time letting me go to therapy. When I come back and I'm being whatever mood I decide to be in, which lately it's been loving in a healthy way, not in a give me attention, I want to please you way. I want to get your approval. I'm probably doing a little bit of both. I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around how he could just think so poorly of himself and so poorly of me, to the point where now my codependency doesn't want to go back to therapy, because I feel like he doesn't approve, he doesn't agree, he doesn't. That lasted a little over an hour last night, he kept saying, that's not what I'm saying, see, I can't talk to you. That's what he kept saying, see, I can't talk to you. You hear what you want to hear, you think what you want to think, you're not listening. I'm a, what am I supposed to do with that information? That you were threatened by this therapist that you haven't met, you know nothing about, but yet you're threatened by him because I haven't bashed on him? That's your only thing that you have to be threatened by him, because I hate him. I don't think he's a jerk. Like the last two therapists, I kind of thought were harsh and mean, and I didn't respond to their way of therapy. I gave it my best effort. They're the ones that let me go. Okay. It wasn't me letting them go. This new guy lets me go, I probably won't do therapy anymore, but I'm not hating his approach. I don't know if it's going anywhere approach, you know? I mean, I'm getting snippets of info of what I'm getting from therapy, but I don't feel like it's this big aha revelation. I don't know, maybe it's not supposed to be. I'm having a really hard time today, and I've come out of it for the most part, but I'm talking about trying to be accountable. So while he's telling me all this, I'm trying to be accountable, and I'm like, honey, why do you keep putting band-aids on it and just letting me go or being okay with this, but then you want to win later when I want to go to my daughter's art festival and you need a win? I mean, those are all really stupid and ridiculous. He knows they're ridiculous, and he admits that they're ridiculous, and I say, stop putting a band-aid on it and just trying to get through the day, or get through that event, or get through that time where you have to get over yourself. Why not just fix the root of the problem? And he gets all angry, I'm doing really well, you don't understand how much progress I've made, and I'm like, okay, you keep shoving your feelings down and sweeping everything under the rug and doing your best to bite your tongue when situations come up, but that's not solving why you are so jealous and insecure. Wouldn't you rather, like, heal the disease than to keep putting a band-aid over it? And I was really adamant that I really want him to get help. Like, start seeing your own therapist weekly, biweekly, two times a week. Heck. I am saying, no, you're seeing our marriage therapist who's not talking about why you're so insecure. We're talking about how you can be accepted as you and I'm accepted as me and how we have to learn to live with each other even though we can't stand each other. Anyway, I gotta go. He just got home. Eventually, I agreed with him, after I had some time to think about it on my own, that if I cleaned a good section of the house, and I was really proud of myself, and he didn't give me any support or any love or any whatever, and then all of a sudden he says, well, you need to figure out why you're so messy and stop being messy to begin with. Instead of appreciating me for the progress I am making, then I would be like torn apart and hurt and like really upset. So I kind of understood where he was coming from in that analogy.
I love Thanks. You, Mommy. I love you very much. All right. Happy birthday tomorrow.
Thank you, Matthew. I appreciate it.
What's this?
You have a loving
for
heart.
Riley. Or Tink. I don't care.
I think it's for Tink.
Tinks.
Storm.
Alright. I'll talk to you later. Bye bye.
Storm, go to bed.
Oh, sorry, Mom.